As of November 9th of 2025, there are currently 41 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 2 less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, representing North America's tallest actively erupting volcano, can be found a mere 70 kilometers southeast of Mexico City. There, the summit of the 22-kilometer-wide Great Top Popocatepetl volcano towers to an impressive height of 5,393 meters or 17,694 feet. Popocatepetl has been near continuously erupting since 1994, largely producing Volcanian and sometimes Strombolian explosions. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In India, the nation's Barren Island volcano produced a new lava flow that headed towards the northeast as eruptive activity intensified. Meanwhile, in Chile, the Planchon-Peteroa volcano produced a series of continuous ash emissions, causing ash to largely fall to the southeast up to 8 miles distant. And in what is this week's top story, we have something a bit unusual. Instead of discussing some new spectacular eruptive activity at a world volcano, we are instead discussing the lack thereof. As, on Hawaii's Big Island, the Kilauea volcano at the beginning of the month was forecasted to produce another episode of hours-long spectacular and sustained tall lava fountaining at its summit between November 4th and November 8th. After all, precursory activity consisting of both weak and strong gas pistoning, including vent lava flows, occurred, something that only happens in the final stage preceding sustained lava fountaining. And yet, November 8th has come and gone, and Kilauea has only continued to produce more of the same precursory activity with no strong lava fountains. So, what exactly happened? Is Kilauea about to break its episodic cycle that has repeated 35 times since December 23rd of last year? To the latter question, I say probably not. What I interpret happened is that an unusually high volume of lava erupted during the precursory summit gas pistoning lava flows. The volume of such appears to have been notably increasing for the past several episodes. As a result, the summit slightly deflated for a time and ever since has been inflating at a far slower rate. This wouldn't have happened if no lava flows were being emplaced. Thus, Kilauea's 36th episode of lava fountaining merely appears to be delayed. In this case, until at least sometime between November 9th and November 11th. A similar delay also occurred before Kilauea's 31st lava fountaining episode. Meanwhile, in India, eruptive activity at the Barren Island volcano, which had been erupting continuously for several months, intensified, sending lava beyond its crater rim. Much of its recent eruptive activity has been Strombolian in nature and due to what I presume was a low magma supply, while lava bombs would occasionally be thrown beyond its central crater rim, very few lava flows occurred. Well, this changed during the last week as lava overflowed its central crater and headed towards the northeast. During a several-day time span, fresh basaltic lava flowed 750 meters or 2,461 feet in that direction. This lava flow still appears to be slowly advancing, but is unlikely, in my opinion, to reach and then enter the Indian Ocean. And, in Chile, intermittent ash emissions occurring due to a weak explosive eruption at the Planchon-Peteroa volcano escalated, with continuous ash emissions occurring on November 6th and 7th. This seemingly marked its strongest eruptive activity since it began intermittently erupting on October 3rd. This caused ash emissions to accumulate on the ground to the volcano's southeast, traveling up to 8 miles in that direction. Because of the pathway ash took, some of it started in Chile, crossed into a section of Argentina, and then back into Chile again. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 8th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.